I'm just going to do a stage 11 walkthrough video and just going to play some of the holes and show you the best ways to attack them. Just show you what way I go really, and you know, why it's the best way to go. So hopefully help a few of you guys out in a few more games. Right, so for this one then you can either go left or you can go where they are now. Depending on the level of your club, if you go left here, the best thing to do is try and land the top left of the fairway as close to the rough as possible, you know, without landing in the rough. I find this way is better for an albatross. It's less bumpy. If you overshoot it, you're obviously going to play a shot like that and land in the rough, and then you're going to have some problems. So I'll go left and show you this way. I like to play it with earth just because of the extra distance. Just put a little side spin on it. So again, where the ball bounces in the middle of that target circle to the second bounce, see that arch? The ball is going to travel the same distance of that again on that second bounce. So you try and aim off accordingly, and you can try and get as close to the rough as possible. So you want to stay left to these, as far left to these cliffs as you can, because obviously you've got to do a curve shot. For some of you people with the lower level clubs, you know, you've probably not got a lot of curve. So you need, you know, all the help you can get. Okay, so for this one then, I'm going to use my moon. A lot of side spin on there. Put a little bit less. So I bounce it onto the fairway again, just to slow that ball down. If you bounce it onto the fairway and then straight onto the green, it's going to go fast. And if you miss, it's going to roll straight off the other side. Whereas this way, it slows right down. And if I miss, it's still going to stay on the green. Right, so it didn't have the legs, but you see what I'm on about. What I'll do is play this hole, play another hole, and then I'll take a couple of the shootouts and show you the shootout holes as well. Play another one then. Okay, so for this one then, you can either go aim where they are now and try and land to the right a little bit, but just past the tree, so you've got a nice straight shot towards the green. Or if you've got a club with decent... again, if you don't get it straight in, it's not going to go too far. All right, just bounce once, bounce twice, onto the green. You're not going to go straight over the back and into the rough. So it's all about thinking about your next shot. You know, with the people who ain't got peacock and shuttle, you don't want to be landing in the rough, because then obviously you've got to deal with the debuff and it's harder. Just see what the shots are, and I might take this one to shoot out. Right, I'm going to miss this one, and then hopefully he gets it in and we'll take it to a shootout. You'll see the shootout hole, or one of them. There's three shootout holes for stage 11. You've got the downhill one. You got one where you can go either left or right around some trees onto the green, and then you got one where you can either go over the top or around to the left or right of a cliff with a little cave going through the middle. I really hate the downhill one. It's got a thin bit of fairway that you have to roll down onto the green. And it just makes up its mind when you take the shot. It just does what it wants when it gets to the bottom. You just got to be lucky, really. Right, so this one then, if you've got club like helm with decent bottom spin on it, you can go straight over the top of these cliffs. Wind dependent, you can go either left or right, but you just have to choose at the time. Not a bad shot, but because he missed, he bounced onto the green and off onto the fairway. Alright, so whereas I wanna bounce on the fairway and onto the green. So that way I'm gonna be closer. Got to play smart. Like that. Right, so we do one more hole in. Hopefully we get the one where you jump the little river. I'll show you guys a little trick shot, yeah. Right, so I'm pretty sure that I was one of the first to try this. Once you get helm 10, I think it is, full top spin on it, aim it like that, don't need no special ball. Alright, and then you can just bounce it straight across. Remember to aim off as normal. A little bit off centre there, but you get the point. You with the lower level clubs, obviously land on the fairway just before the river, and then shoot over there and try and get it in. You can hit it straight over there, obviously with a tailwind. I think with F5, maybe F6. If you haven't got enough wind, obviously you can use the windward ball, give you some extra wind, help you get over there. Things like that. Right, so I'm not going to take this one to a shootout because it's going to be too much effort. I'll play another one after this, I'll take that to a shootout. See if it gives us a different shootout hole. So, like I say, you with the lower level clubs, try and land at the end of the fairway here, just before the rough. Don't do what they've just done and do that. Right, so we'll play one more then. Take this one to shoot out if it's not too much effort, if they're not messing around, missing too much. Okay, so with this one then, if you've got helm, I think 9 can go through the tunnel, full top spin. Just be careful. Obviously, you can hit the roof and go in the water. You still got to aim off as normal. I know helm 10 can definitely go through there. I think you can put full power with helm 10, full top spin through that tunnel. And then obviously helm 11 can definitely go through there. If you use a kangaroo ball going through the tunnel, you're going to get closer to the green, you know, for an easier albatross. But I'll take you this way, straight up the fairway here, because obviously that's where most of you will be going. I'm sure this is his helm there. So you still got to aim off as normal no matter what you do. Try and get past these trees, but obviously not too far where you're going in the rough. So if you do a shot like this and you haven't got a club with a lot of side spin on it, put some bottom spin on it and shoot through the trees. Right, don't always have to go around the trees, you can go through them. Top spin obviously goes lower when you take the shot, so you'll miss the branches, and then just try and hit a bit of rough. Or something near the green, slow ball down for your next shot. Alright, because I've got a club with decent side spin on it, I'm going to use that. Always use the least side spin as possible, because the more side spin you put on it, the bigger the arch of the shot, and the further the ball is going to go if you miss. You know, so always use as little as possible, you know, where you can. Just edging off. That's it. Yeah, where you can, just use the least amount of side spin. So that should be pretty close, if not in. Yeah. Now there you go. Oh, I'm supposed to take that one to a shootout, weren't I? Right, do one more. Keep saying one more. But these little tips and that I've given you guys, it should help you out. You know, it can't make worse. Alright, so this one then, I'm glad I've done another one. So you've got the wall there. You've got a wall where you can either go over the top or you can go around to the right. Or you can go this way. I'll go this way for you guys with the lower level clubs. Obviously you want to land close to that top right edge as possible without going in the rough. For me, it don't really matter, obviously, with the clubs I've got. drink somewhere. Okay, so then for your second shot, obviously you're going to want to try and get as close to that green as possible. Too much size for me. I'll just put it back in and then. It is better going the other way. Obviously, once your clubs are up to it, I think you need at least peacock three to get over that wall. Or you really need to get close to it and go around it with like Mars. So I've just upgraded this unicorn to 4. It's looking pretty good at the minute. I'm liking it. Got very slow needle speed and reduced needle range as well. Pretty hard to miss. Which is good. Right, so I'll play another game then. And this time I'm definitely going to take it to a shootout. And that'll be the last game. Otherwise we'll never get out of here. Alright, come on Jacob. Right, this time then I'll go this other way. Last time I went that way. This time I'll go this way. Get topspin on there. Again, I'm measuring from the first bounce to that second bounce. The ball pretty much going to travel the same again. So you just got to sort of judge it by that. Alright. Remember, if you've got a headwind, sometimes you might have to overpower the shot to get it to go where you want. It is good to know about that, like I say, from the first bounce in the centre of the target circle, you've got an arch to the second bounce. Okay, the ball, when you hit the golf ball's in the centre of the circle, so like just a normal hit, the ball will travel the same distance or near enough as that first arch. Okay, so you can use that when you try and land close to things like the rough and that. It will help you out, otherwise you're going to end up doing stuff like this person. Alright, so then you're going to want to use the wooden wheel, put your little bit of side spin on what you got, and then obviously as much top spin as you've got for this next shot. Let's here, I always rotate my screen so that the wind is facing north. And then all you've got to do is bring the shot down to where you think it is. A bit off that time, but should get onto the green at least. Well, I'm not going to take it to a shootout because these guys just seem to be messing about, but I'm showing you how to play some of the holes the best way to go. I mean, the shootouts are easy enough. Just use the fairway to your advantage, use the rough to your advantage. Once you learn how to do all that, you'll fly through the ranks. Obviously, learning the wind is a major part of the game. Alright guys, so that's stage 11 then. I hope to help you out a little bit. I'm showing you a few shots. A few little tips. So I hope your game improves. And I'll see you on the next video. All right, guys, good luck. I gave you my heart.